I don't know what's going on. I just woke up. My arm itches. What's that? What's going on? We're in some weird place here. I don't recognize this, you guys. Whoa. What is going on? We've landed on some beach, it appears. I'm getting some resources here, it appears. We can get some stone, some wood. All right. Seems like we might be able to use that for stuff. And as you guys can see, I'm a caveman here, you know. Keeping it real. The caveman's always here, but I have no clue what is going on, you guys. We have landed on some... Wow, what is that up there? Okay, that has got to be some sort of ancient alien technology going on up there. But let's just keep moving around here. Maybe we could find a little safe haven. I don't know if the place we, you know, landed is the best place to just stay. Maybe in the shade we could get away from the heat of the sun, but it already says we're cold down there in the corner. And actually, right there, I think it says the middle of the screen, it says the temperature. It looks like it's 50 degrees right now, you guys. So, it's a little chilly out right now to be naked. We should find some clothes, but we got this here level up. You know what, let's put it into movement speed. We're going to want to move fast here, I'm thinking. In this ancient terrain, you know, we're going to have to explore it all. There's going to be quite a bit of area to explore here. I'm picking some berry bushes now, it appears. We're getting some berries, some fiber. Okay, maybe we can use that. That could be another resource. But I'm looking. I'm just not seeing any, you know, animals or anything. So we'll have to keep exploring around, hopefully. Ooh, up the top of this rock might not be the worst place. Set up a camp, a temporary camp. Then we could get a nice view. Yeah, I like this spot. All right. Well, let's see what's going on here because we got our inventory. We'll go ahead over to crafting. All right, then. And we can head over to Ingram's as well, you guys. So we can learn some good tools here. Let's get the campfire. We'll go ahead and get the hatchet as well. Those will probably both be very good tools here early on for a caveman. So let's see. Go ahead and collect some more stuff and see what we can craft. What are we going to need here? We're going to need thatch. Well, I think the only way to acquire thatch is by taking a punch or two at a tree. Now, caveman, we got these nice big arms. We'll just take punches at trees like it ain't no thing. And look at that. We got a stone pickaxe, you guys. So that is awesome. We got a real tool now here. So let's see. Equip that. We can keep moving around here. Oh, wow, you guys. Is that what I think it is? Is that a pteranodon? Are we in some ancient dinosaur land? Oh my gosh, you guys. Well, if that's the case, we need to get shelter ASAP as soon as possible because, yeah, with ancient alien technology going on and dinosaurs, I can't imagine what else is going to be going on around here. So let's just see. To get a hatchet, we're going to need some flint, which we can get from hitting these rocks right here. And we're going to need more thatch, which we'll use the pickaxe for that. And there we go. We got ourselves a stone hatchet. Another level up as well. You know what? We'll throw it into movement speed. Why not? And we got ourselves a spear. Ooh, we're going to need that with all these dinosaurs around, I'm thinking. And then we might want some clothing. Clothing will help us, you know, stay warm and whatnot because we're cold right now. Just to help us stay warm in general. It ain't like anyone else is going to be seeing me. I don't think there's any other people out here. I'm just a caveman out here in my underwear. Like, it ain't no thing. But, yeah, we're definitely going to need some warmth. Let's see, what's it going to take? Well, we already got the stuff for that. I think it's just the plant fibers, right, to craft that. And then we're going to need some spears. What do we need for more of those? Looks like we need a little bit of wood. Well, we're going to need our here hatchet, so let's go ahead and get some of that wood. And I was looking, I seen those pteranodons over there, but you know, those are flying critters, so they probably just already ducked up out of here. And let's see, we got another level up. I mean, these just keep coming in. Put it into movement speed, because yeah, all kinds of dangerous things that just could have tons of speed in them. And we'll start learning house structures. Because like I said, we need to set up a base camp with dangerous dinosaurs around. I keep looking that way. I just feel like there's going to be something coming from that way. So let's head back the other way on the beach, honestly. Because it was where we landed. It might just be safe over there. Maybe that's why we washed up there and why we were able to wake up there. If we, you know, landed in a dangerous area, we probably would have got eaten before we ever got to wake up even. So let's just head back that direction. And we'll hopefully fare well over here. Somewhere around here. Maybe, you know what, let's get on top of these rocks. Again, like I said, getting some height might help us. just long term, so we can get a good view of what's going on. And then we could lure dinos maybe below the cliff to, you know, kill them that way. That could be also a good strategy. But let's see. Is this a solid... Yeah. You know, this is a solid spot. Oh, what is that, you guys? Is that what I think it is? That looks like a dodo, you guys. Is this a dodo? Wow, it's dodos, you guys. So we must be in some sort of weird ancient alien technology world. We got dodos. We got whatever that is. We've seen pteranodons, which were obviously millions of years old. So who knows what's going to be out there. We need to get this house up and rolling. And it appears we are starving right now. So let's just nom some of these berries down. And hopefully we'll be doing good. Let's put these clothes on as well. That should help us save some of our, you know, body heat and whatnot. But there we go. We do have foundations. No, we just learned them. Okay. Well, let's go ahead and see what we need. Looks like we're going to need a bit of thatch. Well, let's see. I guess if there's dodos around here, it must be reasonably safe, right? Because, you know, dodos, they only lived on, like, some island or something. I don't even know. But it's got to be safe, right, if dodos can survive. Let's make some of these foundations. There we go. Three of those crafting up. Still pretty hungry, even though I ate all these berries, you guys. These berries must, like, not have sustenance in them or something. We got another level up. There we go, put that into that. Let's wear the rest of the clothing. Yeah, that's a solid addition, I feel like. We may need to take down some of these dodos here, because I think their hides may provide further clothing for us. Let's see. I like the foundation kind of right there. And we'll put the other one right there, and then maybe one right there. See, that's pretty good, right? A little thatch house working its way up. We're going to need fiber now, huh? Alrighty then. Well, see, I feel like if I killed the dodos too, it could, you know, it gets rid of the other prey around. I feel like dodos, they're prey, right? So they're going to lead other predators to the area. Yeah. Oh, speaking of that, you guys, wow, look at this. Ay, those are some nasty-looking dinosaurs. I do not want to fight those. That's what I'm saying. We got to kill them, you guys, because they're going to come towards us. They're going to eat these dodos. We got to take them out. I'm sorry, you guys. It's survival of the fittest. And I have seen aggressive dinos out there. We got to take this prey out. Oh, I just missed. Oh, another one. There we go. And we're going to get that dodo. Ooh, I just pooped on that dodo. Well, I don't know if we want to eat that dodo, you know. I mean, we just took a casual poop on it. But let's pick our spear up. That's all right. And yeah, those dangerous Dilophos over there. I think that's what they were. They were some kind of raptor-looking thing. Definitely don't want to mess with them. Let's just stay over here. Hopefully get this hut rolling. And yeah, we'll get some more walls. We got plenty of walls crafted, and that'll be pretty good, right? But we need another level up to learn some more housing items. And speaking of that, look at that. So I think there was only those two dodos, you guys, by the house as well. I didn't notice any others. And look at that, you guys. Speaking of that, and that is why I took out those dodos. Because look at that. I mean, if I didn't take him out, he would have just keep eating, you know, the dodo chain, basically. And probably gotten all the way up to my base. And I just do not want to deal with that right now. We want to avoid all the predators at all costs right now. That's what I'm thinking. So let's just keep getting the stuff. What do we need here now? We got points as well. Let's learn the rest of the housing then, right? Because that should enclose us. And let's go ahead and just get this going. Yeah, here. There we go. And we're going to need a door. Okay, well, we pretty much need everything looking at it. We have a little bit of fiber, but it's just not going to be enough. I don't want to roam into the woods, man. I mean, it's just dangerous, but that's just where the resources are, so we're going to have to. I feel like if we stay on the edge, that's the best chance. We're dehydrated. I think berries can sustain that, right? Can they help with that? It looks like they do. Oh, look at that, you guys. Yeah, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3. Oh, yeah, really cranking up that hydration, you guys. So we're going to need to head down to the water at some point, probably. Or there might be a stream, actually. I think there might be a stream back over here that I know about. And if you look at it, just kind of looks like it opens up again. See, it's not very densely forested. You know, this is such a dangerous decision, but I'm going to go over here. We're going to get up on top of this rock and see what's going on. Yeah, this is not the area that I think it is. So let's just get out of here. There's no stream over there. There's definitely no stream over there. It just looked like there was kind of like a open plain area. Well, it's not really a plain. Plains are big. I don't know, a meadow. I guess a meadow. Yeah, that's a good word for it. But look, there's dodos right here. We'll leave that one. We will leave that one. I was just trying to take those other ones out to honestly get the threats away. I didn't want to lead them towards the base. And it looks like there's a good amount of resources on the beach. I probably should be utilizing this stuff. But, you know, we'll figure it out. We're definitely dehydrated, though. It's just preventing us from gaining stamina and stuff. Let's just down these, because these white berries, as you can see, our stamina just took a huge increase. The white berries, they give us a nice little stamina boost. So that'll help us if we ever, you know, need to do that. But they also dehydrate you. Oh, I mean, we were already dehydrated, so it didn't really affect us too much. Wow, look at all this, you guys. Giant shark under there. Some dolphin-looking critter. And I think those are coelacanths, as well as manta rays even. Wow, you guys. I mean, there is going to be plenty of wildlife to explore in this world, dude. We're just going to have to get geared up to do that first, because we just do not have a setup yet. And is that something over there through the trees? Like, right there, you guys see that? Is that, like, the neck of a creature or something that's just not moving? I bet that's a rock, because, you know, it probably would have moved. But who knows? That definitely looks a little dangerous. Let's keep crafting stuff, though. We're going to need a door, as well as some ceilings. So we're going to need some more wood, it looks like. Grab a bit of that, just like that, hater. And there we go. We should be able to craft more of them, huh? Maybe we need fiber next. I mean, it's really simple. You only need the three resources for it, so you just kind of alternate between the three, and you'll get what you need eventually. There we go. Another ceiling. I think we have, yeah, our door and our doorway. So all we need is a bunch of walls. Let's just crank out some walls then. And yeah, we'll be good to go. We're quite slow as well because we're crafting, which is unfortunate. I guess we'll just down more berries to sustain our hunger. I mean, we've eaten so many berries. I mean, it's probably in the hundreds at this point, but... you know, whatever. That's how cavemen roll. They are hard-working cavemen, so they gotta eat all the time. We gotta get some meat in our diet, I'm thinking, because that'll definitely help balance the diet here. We need to get the campfire going, which is gonna require a bit of stone and thatch, so I think we'll get that. Ooh, a nice dodo friend. So, there we go, a little bit of stone. And maybe we can make one of those dodos our friend, you know, try to tame him or something, do something like that. Or maybe get him to lay some eggs for us, you know, get a whole dodo clan going. I don't know if this is a female, though. Let's check it out. Let's check it out. Are you a female? No, you're a male. Well, you can't really lay eggs, man. I don't think that's how that works, so. Aw, dude, I just saw something disappear. I think that was poop or something. Maybe naturally decomposing into the ground or something, but. Let's go. Oh, I did not mean to do that. Well, rip, we're crafting another door frame. Well, we could save that for a future house, right? So that's okay. I think I want to put the door here. But I guess the door over here probably makes more sense, right? The door over here probably makes more sense. So we'll put it, like, right there in that corner. And then let's place all of these walls down, and we should be good to go, you guys. This is a nice little hut going. This is actually pretty sweet. I think we're going to be safe from at least, you know, that dangerous little raptor thing I saw. And maybe, you know, potential threats as well. Maybe just nothing big yet. But dude, I want to explore that ancient alien stuff. That is just wild. As well as that tree. I mean, look at that tree, you guys. What is this, from Avatar? I mean, dude, that's just a tree. That's all I know, bro. That's a big tree. So, let's see. We do need the campfire. That is definitely something I wanted. Let's craft that up. We have another level up. And we've been putting them all into movement speed so far, but... you know what, I think carry weight could also be helpful, you know, so we could carry more resources back and forth. And a simple bed, that's going to be very helpful. Simple bed, definitely, but it says it requires the hide sleeping bag, so let's go ahead and learn that first. And then we're a few points short on Ingram points up there, it says, so let's just go ahead and save them for the next level. And we'll place our campfire, and we might go try to take on those nasty little raptor things over there, because we have the protection of our base now. We could just run back over here if we really need to, so. Yeah, the fire doesn't really look right there, so let's just put it out in the front on the stone. Yeah, look at that. Nice little place. You can set some chairs up around the campfire and have some campfire stories, but I'm all by myself, you guys. There's no one to tell no stories to.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
It's alright, maybe we could get some friends here, like I was saying, maybe a dodo friend or something. Let's see, let's go ahead and explore, and I don't know, I saw him over here, he was like right here, you guys, do you remember? I pointed him out, he was like on the edge of this cliff, but I don't know where it roamed, and I really do not want to go chasing him into the, like, forest, you know, because that's just not a good idea, I feel like. Chase him into that forest. Yeah, that's his advantage, you know. Let's play to my advantage. Wait, is that him? That is him right there, that red little Dilo. I think that's what I'm pretty sure that's what it is, a Dilophosaurus, you guys, the spitting creature. So, you know what? Let's just go ahead and move in on him. And if we could strike fast enough and avoid his spit, we should be good to go. Let's just hit him with a spear when he doesn't see it coming.
Oh, you guys! Wow! Caveman! Caveman! Ooga!
We just gave it to that Dilophosaurus, you guys. That was actually awesome. I mean, I just hid behind the rock. He never even saw it coming. Well, that's one threat eliminated. We did see two way back when attacking those dodos. So there still is another potential threat on, you know, the... It's speaking of that, I think that's what I just came across, you guys. Uh-oh. Is that what I think it is? I think it is. I don't know. I heard something. I saw something. I have no clue what that was, you guys. That was gnarly. It was in the bushes, like, right there, dude. Is it just hiding in the bushes? I'm not gonna wait. I'm not even gonna try, dude. That is just insane. Okay, well, let's go ahead and put some more. Ooh, we have cooked meat in here, you guys, so that's some real sustenance. Let's go ahead and put the rest of that up in there. We'll go ahead and munch down some of these cooked meats, and look at that, you guys. That's really sustaining our hunger, yeah. Way more than those berries we're doing. We had to nom so many berries here. Just as an example, I'll eat two berries compared to two pieces of meat, you guys. I mean, just look at that. It's so crazy, the difference. So yeah, we're definitely going to want to use meat as our main source here. The berries just don't provide enough sustenance. But yeah, we were trying to save levels. Oh my gosh, you guys. I knew what I saw, and it was right there in front of me. Okay, we hit him. He's coming for us now. Second spear to him. Oh, he's still going, you guys. What? Oh my gosh. Uh-oh. He just tried to spit us. Oh my gosh. We gotta man fight him. We gotta man fight him, you guys. Oh man. This is not going well. This is not going well, you guys. Wow. Level 140. Avoid the spit. Oh no. Wait, it's running. Why are you running? Wait, let's give him some punches. It might be high on torpor, actually. Oh no, 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 no. I don't think it's high on torpor. It was playing a game. It was trying to bait me. I might die, actually, you guys. This is getting dangerous. Let's try to get in the house. Let's try to get in the house. Okay, we're in the house. Let's try to eat some meat, because I know cooked meat can actually sustain our hunger. Or our health is what I meant. You see that? Our health is going up quite a bit. So that's really good. We were really low on health. And now, hopefully, he's still very low, and we got a little bit of a health boost. Come on, can we take him out? He's so strong, you guys. We might not be able to kill this guy. But we're going to have to make more spears. We're going to have to. That's our only choice. Where is he? He's over there. He's really slow, actually. He might have been attacking something at the base or something. Oh, wait, no. Let's get around these... Oh, no, these rocks are going to trap us. Wait, he's not very smart. He's not very smart. And there's a bird now, you guys. I don't know if that bird-looking thing is going to be mad or nasty. Let's get in the house. We'll craft ourselves some more spears, right? And we should be good to go. Okay, only one. Dang it, we're short on fiber. I thought we could have made two with the amount of stuff. I didn't know we needed fiber. Dang it, you guys, if I could just access our fire. Oh, he's running. That's what I was saying. See, access the fire. We'll get our cooked meats back out of here, and we should be good to go now. We do have a good amount of food. Yeah, he still wants it, you guys. This Dilophosaurus wants to fight, but he's just not very smart. His IQ does not match his level, that is for sure. He's like a level 140, but bro, that IQ is like a 14. Let's see. Let's make another spear, and hopefully we can kill this guy. Ooh, our poop. Let's go ahead and pick that up. You never know what we could do with that. But let's see. Is he still here? I wonder if we could lead him in the fire. Wait, is he in the fire? Just looking at the fire. Did you guys see that? He ate the fire. He ate the fire, you guys. He ate the campfire. What? Okay. Die. You need to die. You need to die. Oh my gosh, this thing is so strong. This is insane, you guys. I don't understand. Why is it so strong? Let's just kill it. I mean, let's just kill it. Come on. Die, man. Give me some resources. Don't spit at me, bro. Oh no, he's spitting. He's really bloody. Look how bloody it is. Okay, it's running. It must be dead. Let's try to stab him. Yeah, look, we stabbed him to death. Okay, there we go. Dude, he was taking him to the head. I don't understand. Wow, level 140. That would have honestly been a nice tame, though, you guys, if we could have tried to tame it, you know, get it on our side. Because it was so strong, dude. That was insane. It even ate our campfire and everything. Let's go ahead and make another campfire, then. That is unfortunate stuff. We're going to need some more stones. Well, let's go ahead and grab those up. Sweet. Not too bad. Nice, dude. I mean, that almost went bad, you guys. But we went ahead and took him down. That was definitely a close call. And it looks like we're losing health still, you guys. I don't know if he inflicted some kind of bleeding on us or he attacked us so bad that we have some kind of bone broken or something. I have no clue, but we're dying. That's all I know. Let's warm up by the campfire, maybe. get some campfire going, eat some food. Yeah, we're gonna be okay. I think we're gonna be okay. And we did level up in the process of that chaos. We can now make the simple bed, which is very good because a simple bed allows us to respawn if we die, at least at our base. We could still respawn if we die, just, you know, not at our base, which could end bad. You know, could just respawn basically in a total different place, and you're just like, what? And yeah, so let's get the bed going. I don't know what we really need for it. Looks like just thatch now, so let's just grab a whole bunch of thatch. Well, only one thatch from that tree. I think that's because we were already beating it up and hitting it. I'm hoping. I hear footsteps. Were those my footsteps, or were those dinosaur footsteps? I really swear, dude, I heard something big. It might have just been my footsteps, though. Who knows? Who knows, man? Let's just keep getting some thatch. Do we have enough now to make the bed? Yes, we do, right? No, we don't. Wow. Six thatch off. That's not too bad, then. There we go. Now we can make ourselves a simple bed. What do we need to make a hat? Looks like some fiber. You know, I think that's the next objective. Let's work on a full set of clothing, right? We're very cold out here. I feel like a full set of clothing is going to really protect us from, you know, just the heat or the cold elements so we can stay heated. That's right. But we got our campfire. I guess we can always just stay around that. And this one placed a little weird. It's kind of floating and stuff. I don't really like that. Let's just rebuild it, right? Because it's probably cheap. Apparently not. Let's rebuild it just like that. And hopefully it'll place normal this time. I guess it was on a weird little stone or something. I have no clue. Whatever. Can we get it to place like how it was? You know, where it just kind of looked cool or something? It was pretty good the first time, and the Dilo just had to eat our campfire, which just was not cool. I don't know why Dilo had to do that. I think that looks better. It doesn't look as bad, so that's pretty good, you guys. Anyway, we got our simple bed. Let's actually go ahead and place our simple bed down, you guys. And there's nothing in the house, so let's just start it out right here in the corner. And sweet. Now we have a respawn point, you guys. That's going to be a big step to, you know, what we're going to want to do here. And yeah, I mean, I think we're surviving here well for day one. I don't know what else we're going to want to do here. Maybe just get a little bit of resources, right? I think a little bit of resource grind in here real quick wouldn't be a bad idea. And actually make that clothing. Yeah, we do want to make our clothing. The hat, as well as the gloves and the boots. I do want to make the boots, though, over gloves. You know, I feel like boots are a bit of a priority there. So let's go ahead and grab those boots. And yeah, we should be good to go. Go ahead and equip these real quick. There we go. Not too bad. And let's go ahead and head down to the water, because we're actually dehydrated, you know. We're getting dehydration going on. I think we're dying from that, too. So let's just go ahead and get a drink. Hopefully that'll solve that, you know, problem. Can we get a drink? We gotta go all the way in the water for some reason. Our health is not doing well, though, you guys. After those Dilophosaurus fights, we've just not been able to really recover. I'm eating this cooked meat because it, you know, sustains our health. It does improve the health, but it's just not. We're not healing, so we're going to have to figure that out. Let's go ahead and put more meat in our fire here. Yeah, we still have a bunch of meat to cook, so let's just keep cooking it, and we should be good to go there. Let's head over to the house. Hopefully, maybe some safety in the house. What do we need to do? We've got a good amount of Ingram points. Huh. I think bolas could be a good thing, but yeah, let's just learn bolas. It's getting pretty cold outside, so I don't know if we can hang out here. Yeah, that I think we're dying because we're outside, you guys, actually. You see that ice cube in the corner down there? And yeah, actually, looking at the temperature, it's 35 degrees Fahrenheit. No wonder we're dying when we're outside. We don't have any sort of suitable, you know, clothing to be outside in that temperature. So let's just stay inside for the night, honestly, you guys. That might be our best solution, so yeah, I think we'll go ahead and do that. I don't know if there's anything else we want to learn, though, here. Maybe we could actually get this mortar and pestle thing going. Yeah, do you think we could craft that? Do we have the hides to craft it? I bet we don't, because we spent all our hides, yeah, on the other stuff. Well, there's this bird flying out here. I think we could spear a bird, you guys? Let's try to spear a bird, because you know what? This thing's just kind of flying around, being a little odd. I don't know if I like its look. So let's just go ahead and take it out. Come on, bird, fly this way. Fly, like, right in line with my spear, so I could just, like, spear you, bro. we might have to land a
wow, you attacked me!
Oh my gosh, you guys, that is not good. So, now he's coming right for me. I missed with that spear. Spears are expensive, I can't just be tossing them to the ground. Yeah, let's get this angle, that way if we miss it, yeah, it goes back anyway. Oh my gosh, you guys, this bird's about to kill us. Let's get inside the house. This is really just out of control. Wow. Bird be strong, huh? Now we don't want to eat berries. We gotta eat our cooked meat, because that definitely sustains our health. Can we craft more spears even? What are those gonna take? More wood. Okay. Wow, he's attacking the house, you guys. Okay, he doesn't do too much damage, it seems like, though. I hope, at least. So let's just try to make some spears. No. Oh my gosh. Wow, you guys. Well, I guess stepping outside wasn't the right idea. We got killed by a raptor, you guys. Well, let's respawn at our bed. It's a good thing we made a bed. Wow. Well, now there's a raptor outside, too. Huh. Well, we didn't lose too much stuff. At least we got a bed going. But, yeah. Dang it, that's literally the raptor right there, you guys. I don't know if you could see him. It's so dark out right now. Gosh, you guys, this is just not gonna go well, is it? I would like to get my stuff, you guys. The stuff is inside that green beacon. Let's just go for it. I cannot see a thing. Is the raptor going to come for me? Where is the raptor? See, that's the thing. I can't even tell where the raptor is, you guys. Oh my gosh, you guys. This is so bad. Just go for it. Go for it. Just go for it. Just go for it. We got our stuff. We got our stuff. The bird's on us. The bird's on us. He's eating our berries or something, it says, but that's no problem. We actually got our stuff, you guys. Wow. Okay, the bird's on the house. That's, you know, not as bad as things, you know, could be. The bird's probably gonna break the house. We don't need to know that. Apparently the bird can hit through the house, or was that because I opened the door at the right time? That probably was because of the bird opening the door at the right time. Why does the bird hit so hard, though, bro? I don't know. Where even is it? Can I tell? I can't even tell. It's in the house. Can't tell where it is. Okay, it just struck, so it's not gonna strike again. Recently, I don't think they strike like super quick, you know what I'm saying? Take a bit of time. Is it coming for me or is it coming for the house at this point? If you step on the house, like, might stay at the fire for a second. The fire's warm enough. The fire's not warm enough. We need to be in the house. That's the problem. Take all of our resources out of there. Let's go make more spears with that wood that we just acquired, because I think we can, right? Good. Yep. Another spear, you guys. And then we could go ahead, go hit a rock like once, and it should give us enough to make another few spear. Hopefully, yes, make another spear. And hopefully we can take this bird on. I mean, this is getting a bit of a struggle. And it's very dark. I mean, gosh, I cannot see nothing without this campfire. So, like, what am I going to do here? Is he just going to leave off? Is he going to bugger off? We just bugger off for... If I could repair the roofs, it would help. But it, like, has this cooldown timer. So, like, I got to wait, apparently, to do all that. Yeah, he's relentless. He's relentless, dude. So, honestly, I want to just run. I want to just run down to the beach and try to survive the night on the beach, because I don't know what's going on up here, bro. Our house is getting out of control. Let's just leave and go to the beach for the night or something. Well, you guys, after that icky thornous bird was just raiding my base up there, we just went down the hill. I don't even know. You might be able to see my base up there. It's just right up the hill. Like, we decided to build a little one-by-one here, put a fire in it, you know, and just, this is the only way I could survive the night, so. But either way, I was looking outside, right? And look at that, you guys. Oh my gosh, don't tell me. Don't tell me. We admire beauty and this happens. Wow. Are we gonna die here? Don't tell me we're gonna die here. Okay, we lived that, you guys. That was, wow. Just wow. Anyway, we killed the Dilophosaurus. But look at the beauty, guys, before we die here casually. I mean, the Northern Borealis or the Northern Lights, whatever it's called, dude. It's happening, and that's epic as heck. But we got to get back inside because, as you can see, that Dilo messed us up, and we're already almost dead again. So, yeah, at least we got food, though, from him. And then we'll put thatch in there to run that fire. But, yeah, you guys, I'm just going to go ahead and wait the rest of the night out in this campfire, and we will see you guys here in the morning. Well, you guys, we survived the night down here in this little one-by-one. Because, as you guys remember, the Ichthyornis thing, seagulls, I think they are or something, were attacking our base? I don't know. But whatever, we had to make a campfire down here and survive in this little house. Because even without the campfire, we were still dying. So we would have had to move a campfire up into our other house anyways, eventually. But let's just head back up there. And there obviously is a raptor still up here. We have a level up that I guess we did acquire over the night. Let's put it into movement speed for sure this time. We have another level up? Okay, we acquired multiple level ups overnight. Hey, I'm not going to be mad. Let's put another one into movement speed. Why not? And let's just try to see where this raptor is, you guys. Let's get a quick scout on what's going on up here, if we can move in back up here or not. I'm going to call it safe besides this dumb bird. Why has this bird got such a problem with us, bro? It's just a seagull. Oh, there's two of them. That's just great.
Well, you guys, it looks like this house might be taken over by seagulls for now, but we'll have to just move out or, I don't know, move along the beach further. It was just a day one little hut, whatever. So that's pretty cool. And hey, look, there's some other birds hanging out down here. That one looks quite a bit bigger, so let's just avoid that one. Well, you know what? I think that's going to do it for this episode, you guys. So thank you guys all very much for watching, and we'll see you guys here next time with some more Ark Survival Evolved here on Fajor, where hopefully we can make a, you know, permanent base or something of some kind, because our base got totally taken over by, you know, those seagulls and the raptor, too, that killed us there, unfortunately. At least we got our stuff back right away, because, yeah, that would have sucked if we just lost all our stuff. But yeah, thank you guys all very much for watching, and I'll see you guys here next time with some more Ark Survival Evolved. Oh, bye there.